they show you the pressure regulators, you know what is the principle of pressure regulator. Because wow, many places, wherever I have gone as an examiner, many times when we ask the student to show the pressure regulator, he will be searching for the pressure regulator because you never have used these machines. When he has never have used these machines, in a modern workstation, everything is covered. Everything is inside. You don't see anything, isn't it? Except probably in some of the machines, you can see the flow meters. It's still more modern and high-tech machines. You don't have even a flow meter. So it's a virtual flow meter you can have. Everything you adjust on the monitor, it flows out, isn't it? So that type of thing, if somebody is, like I was telling you, like how do you provide anesthesia for a cesarean section? She started telling GA with direct arterial line, a central vein, and then, see, people who have worked in such places, they start talking like that, and they may not have seen these kind of machines. Our students here, they are very fortunate. We have 18 of these machines and we have very less number of workstations. We have had only 12 workstations. So our students use both. So they know both. There are absolutely no problem for them to answer. But many of you might not have seen these machines. So these are the pressure regulators. See, that's why I wanted this. This one pressure regulator here, this one pressure regulator here. So up to the pressure regulator, you have high pressure regulators. So the cylinders, the yoke assembly, the pressure regulators. So these three are the parts of a high pressure system. So downstream of the pressure regulator is now the intermediate system. So you should know what is upstream and downstream. Downstream is always towards the patient. Whatever is going towards the patient is downstream. Whatever that is away from the patient is the upstream. Okay. Now we know that the intermediate pressure system mainly consists of, now you know alarm systems are there, the oxygen failure alarm systems are one of the things, these are the alarm systems supposed to be at the first rate, and the oxygen flush is another part of the intermediate pressure system, this is the oxygen flush, and you also have in the modern workstations the oxygen fail-safe device. Oxygen fail-safe device, which were not there in the older machines. We had the same pressure regulators used to work as oxygen fail-safe, the pressure regulator. So the master and slave pressure regulators, they used to work as oxygen fail-safe system. Now we have a separate fail-safe system which is there in the intermediate system. So in the intermediate system, you have sometimes in Datex Omega, you have second stage pressure regulators also there. In Datex Omega you have second stage pressure regulators. These pressure regulators will reduce the pressure from 2750 psi to 45 psi. The second stage pressure regulators just upstream of the flow meters. Second stage pressure regulators are present just upstream, just before the flow meters. You have second stage pressure regulators which reduce the pressure again from 45 psi to oxygen of 14 psi and nitrous oxide of 28 psi. So that is about second stage pressure regulators. They are a part of intermediate pressure system and they are only present in data exchange. So in breakers, we don't have second stage pressure regulators. There we have, instead of second stage pressure regulator, we have flow restrictors. That is, you don't see anything, it is inside. Let me explain to you later. So what you have as far as the intermediate pressure system, you have the oxygen failure alarms are there. Then oxygen flush, then fail-safe valves, and then second stage pressure. So, and sometimes even the flow control knobs are also included as the intermediate flow control knob. So after the flow control knobs, what you have is the flow control valves in the flow meter. That is called as a flow meter assembly. So from the flow meter valves onwards is a low flow system. Low pressure system. So from knobs, it is in the intermediate system only, up to the knobs, because the pressure is still higher up to the knobs. So after the knobs only the pressure drops. But here, even up to the knobs, you can have a pressure of 14 psig of oxygen and 28 psig of nitrous oxide when you have a second stage pressure. So when you have flow restrictors, especially in case of dragon, you don't have second stage pressure regulators. The 60 psig of the pipeline systems and 45 psig of the cylinders, the downstream of pressure regulators, they come And as they are entering the, into the flow meter, just before that, the tubes, what are the tubes are there, they are suddenly narrow. And they open up. They are suddenly narrow, that is they are called as actually the flow restrictors. Actually they don't restrict the flow, but they restrict the pressures. You know, based on Bernoulli's principle. Bernoulli's principle is the one in laminar flow. When the flow encounters a narrowing, the pressure drops, the flow increases. So that's what is Bernoulli. Based on that Bernoulli's principle, instead of pressure, second stage pressure regulators, what they have in Draeger is flow restrictors. So just before the pipes enter the, like for example here, the pipings are entering the flow meter. Just before that you have the flow restrictors inside. You don't see outside. Inside it is suddenly narrowed and opened up again. So the, when the pressure comes to the flow meters, it's much lower. So then just like the second stage pressure regulator.
And until flow restrictors, it is intermediate, after that it is lower.
Flow restrictors also will not reduce the pressure to such a low pressure. Like even 14 psig and 28 psig are still low, not low
pressure. Then it acts as a second.
Yeah, instead of second stage pressure regulators, they have reduced the cost. You know, pressure regulators are costly. So a simple way of using reducing the pressures, they have just narrowed it and then widened it. So the pressure drops and then the flow increases. So actually, they are not flow restrictors. They actually increase the flow. Though they are called as flow restrictors, that is only in Draeger. So sometimes you will ask, okay, you will be talking about the second stage pressure regulators. Okay, is second stage pressure regulator is present in all the companies. So these two giants are there who manufacture all over the world the anesthesia workstations. Now Draeger and then Datex Lumina now is bought over by GE. Now the GE machines you have. Otherwise they were originally Datex Lumina only. Now bought over by GE. So now sometimes you call it as GE machines also. So that's how there are some certain differences between GE machines and Datex current Draeger machines. Okay, now from the flow control valve which will be inside, you have the low pressure system. So just beyond the flow control valves have many times just between the flow control valve and the knobs, you have in Datex Lumina you have Link 25 system. Which again is very important as far as the amount of oxygen and nitrous oxide going to the patient. So it will not allow any time less than 25% of the total flow of oxygen to be delivered to the patient. That's why it is called as Link 25. And the link starts only when the oxygen, total percentage of oxygen comes down below 25 or below. So then only the link occurs between oxygen and nitrous oxide. That link is there with a chain and a spindle. So the link occurs only when oxygen, percentage of oxygen comes to 25 or below. Otherwise there won't be any link. So the alignment will not occur. So they are both the chain is there, the alignment and the link will occur only. That's why it is called as Link 25. So sometimes they'll ask you why it's called as Link 25. So the linking occurs only once it drops down to 25. Then only if you move oxygen, if you move nitrous oxide, oxygen also moves.
So this is we're talking about in percentage
when comparing. Link 25 is percentage.
Percentage.
It is only percentage of total flow. So suppose you are having 6 liters, so you have 4 liters of nitrous and 2 liters of oxygen. Now the link will engage. The chain will engage the both the sprockets. You have the sprockets with 14 teeth for nitrous oxide, 28 teeth for oxygen. So one rotation of nitrous oxide will turn oxygen twice. So it is 28 teeth. So that we will, I'll explain to you how it occurs. It is a Link 25. That's only present in case of Datex Lumina. It's purely mechanical. Whereas in case of Draeger, you don't have Link 25. You have ORMC, oxygen ratio monitor control, or one rotation of nitrous oxide will rotate oxygen. So that what we want is more oxygen to be delivered to the patient. We don't want more nitrous oxide. Because oxygen is 28 teeth. One rotation of 14, so that can rotate the nitrous twice. So that is one thing. And again, how do we know that whether it is a Link 25 or ORMC? How do we know that it is ORMC or Link 25? What is there in this machine? So to start with, I want to open only nitrous.
It won't open.
In case of Link 25. 25, you cannot open at all. So if you open nitrous, you cannot alone open nitrous. So auxin also will not open. Whereas in ORMC, if you try to open nitrous, auxin also will not. So that's how you can know what, whether ORMC is there in your machine or the link 25 is there. So just remember that you have the low pressure system beyond the flow control valves. Okay, that also you will have a safety problem system, either link 25 or also called as a proportionality divider. Then see that the proportion between auxin and nitrous oxide is always, auxin will be 25% or above. So that's what they are proportionating devices, they are called as. So you have the proportionating devices, you have the flow control, flow meter assembly. The whole thing is called as flow meter assembly. Then you have the hind bar or the back bar, that is a back bar, and you have provision for mounting the vaporizers also there. And you have that side here, check valve and a pop-up valve. So that one, you know that there is a check valve and there is a pop-up valve. So this, the broad one is a check valve and the top one is a pop-up valve. So this is the check valve, this is a pop-up valve. Okay, can you see from there also? Pop-up valve and check valve. So this only check valve is only present in case of GE machines. Regular machines, we don't have check valve. So that's again another difference you should always know about. Because there's a check valve, you can't go for positive pressure leak test. You have to go for only a negative pressure leak test for GE machines. Because the check valve is there, you can check only up to this level. You can't check that side. Because it will not allow the pressure to move to the other side. So no positive pressure leak test in GE machines. Whereas Dräger, you don't have the check valve. So because no check valve is there, you can go for both positive pressure leak test and a negative pressure leak test. And negative pressure leak test is called as a universal check, leak test. Universal, because you can go for whether check valve is there or no check valve is not there also, you can go for the negative pressure leak test. That's why it's called as a universal leak test. Now let us start with the high pressure system. So what are the safety pressure system, safety features in the high pressure system? They can just ask you what are the safety features that are there in the high pressure system. So what you should start is, we'll explain at the end, checking of the analysis. Auxin? No, this machine we don't have. Auxiliary auxin, usually some of the auxiliary auxin. And that's your future.